Exactly when did President Trump learn of the breach of the Capitol? And what specific actions did he take to bring the rioting to an end? And when did he take them? Please be as detailed as possible.
Mr. Van Veen?
The House managers have given us absolutely no evidence, the other on to that question. We're able to piece together a timeline, and it goes all the way back to December 31st, January 2nd. There is a lot of interaction between the authorities and getting folks to have security beforehand. On the day, we have a tweet at 2:38, so it was certainly sometime before then. With the rush to bring this impeachment, there's been absolutely no investigation into that. And that's the problem with this entire proceeding. The House managers did zero investigation, and the American people deserve a lot better than coming in here with no evidence, hearsay on top of hearsay, on top of reports that are of hearsay. Due process is required here, and that was denied.
Exactly when did the president learn of the breach at the Capitol, and what steps did he take to address the violence? Please be as detailed as possible.
Just wish to respond.
Mr. President, senators, this attack was on live TV, on all major networks, in real time. The president, as president, has access to intelligence information, including reports from inside the Capitol. He knew the violence that was underway. He knew the severity of the threats. And most importantly, he knew that Capitol Police were overwhelmingly outnumbered and in a fight for their lives against thousands of insurgents with weapons. We know he knew that. We know that he did not send any individuals. We did not hear any tweets. We did not hear him tell those individuals, stop. This is wrong. You must go back. We did not hear that. So what else did the president do? We are unclear. But we believe it was a dereliction of his duty. And that was because he was the one who had caused them to come to the Capitol, and they were doing what he asked them to do. So there was no need for him to stop them from what they were engaged in. But one of the things I would like to ask is, we still have not heard and posed to you all the questions that were raised by Mr. Raskin, Manager Raskin, in his closing argument. Why did the President Trump not tell the protesters to stop as soon as he learned about it? Why did President Trump do nothing to stop the attack for 2 hours after the attack began? Why did President Trump do nothing to help protect the Capitol and law enforcement battling the insurgents? You saw the body cam of a Capitol police officer at 4:29, still fighting. 4:29 after, since what time? 1, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Why did he not condemn the violent insurrection on January 6th? Those are the questions that we have as well. And the reason this question keeps coming up is because the answer is nothing.
Mr. President.
The Senator from Utah.
I send a question to the desk.
The Senator from Utah, Mr. Romney, on behalf of himself and Senator Collins. It's a question, and clerk will read it. Oh, and I apologize. The question is for both sides, so the time will be evenly divided.
When President Trump sent the disparaging tweet at 2:24 p.m. regarding Vice President Pence, was he aware that Vice President had been removed from the Senate by the Secret Service for his safety?
The House Manager. And time will be evenly divided between. Of course, would the clerk read the question again?
When President Trump sent the disparaging tweet at 2:24 p.m. regarding Vice President Pence, was he aware that the Vice President had been removed from the Senate by the Secret Service for his safety?
The House of Representatives, managers are recognized 2.5 minutes.
Thank you. Well, let me tell you what he said at 2:24 p.m. He said Mike Pence didn't have the courage to do what should have been done to protect our country and our Constitution. USA demands the truth. And you know by now what was all over the media. You couldn't turn on the television, couldn't turn on the radio, couldn't consume any media, or probably take any phone calls or anything else without hearing about this, and also hearing about the Vice President. And here's what Donald Trump had to know at that time, because the whole world knew it, all of us knew it. Live television had, by this point, shown that the insurgents were already inside the building, and that they had weapons, and that the police were outnumbered. And here are the facts that are not in dispute. Donald Trump had not taken any measures to send help to the overwhelmed Capitol Police. As president, at that point, when you see all this going on and the people around you are imploring you to do something, and your vice president is there, why wouldn't you do it? Donald Trump had not publicly condemned the attack, the attackers, or told them to stand down, despite multiple pleas to do so. And Donald Trump hadn't even acknowledged the attack. And after Wednesday's trial portion concluded, Senator Tuberville spoke to reporters and confirmed the call that he had with the president and did not dispute Manager Cicilline's description in any way that there was a call between he and the president around the time that Mike Pence was being ushered out of the chamber. And that was shortly after 2 p.m. And Senator Tuberville specifically said that he told the president, "Mr. President, they just took the vice president out. I've got to go." That was shortly after 2 p.m. There were still hours of chaos and carnage and mayhem. The vice president and his family were still in danger at that point. Our commander-in-chief did nothing.
Counsel for the former president.
The answer is no. At no point was the president informed the vice president was in any danger, because the House rushed through this impeachment in 7 days with no evidence. There is nothing at all in the record on this point, because the House failed to do even a minimum amount of due diligence. What the president did know is that there was a violent there was a violent riot happening at the Capitol. That's why he repeatedly called via tweet and via video for the riots to stop, to be peaceful, to respect Capitol Police and law enforcement, and to commit no violence and to go home. But to be clear, this is an article of impeachment for incitement. This is not an article of impeachment for anything else. It's a one count. They could have charged anything they wanted. They chose to charge incitement. So that the question, although answered directly no, it's not really relevant to the charges for the impeachment in this case. And I just wanted to clear up one more thing. Mr. Castro, in his first answer, may have spoke, but what he said was Mr. Trump had said, fight to the death. That's false. I'm hoping he misspoke. Thank you.
The defense counsel made a point about something that I read earlier. Defense counsel suggested I misspoke. And I just want to clarify for the record that the tweet I referenced, let me read you the tweet directly. If a Democrat presidential candidate had an election rigged and stolen with proof of such acts at a level never seen before, the Democrat senators would consider it an act of war and fight to the death. Mitch and the Republicans do nothing, just want to let it pass. No fight. So Donald Trump was equating what Democrats would do if their election was stolen. He said they'd fight to the death. Why do you think he sends that tweet? Because he's trying to say, hey, the other side would fight to the death, so you should fight to the death. I mean, do we read that any other way?
Mr. President,
the senator from Missouri.
Mr. President, on my behalf and on behalf of Senator Kramer, I send a question to the desk.
Senator Hawley, on behalf of himself and Senator Kramer, send a question for the council and House manager. And following our procedure, the first one to respond will be after it's read will be the counsel for the former president.
If the Senate's power to disqualify is not derivative of the power to remove a convicted president from office, could the Senate disqualify a sitting president but not remove him or her? If the Senate's power to disqualify is not derivative of the power to remove a convicted president from office, could the Senate disqualify a sitting president but not remove him or her?
President has 2.5 minutes.
No. But I can't let this rest. Mr. Castro attributed a statement the time before last that he was up here that Donald Trump had told his people to fight to the death. I'm not from here. I'm not like you guys. I was being very polite and given an opportunity to correct the record, and I thought that's exactly what he would do. But instead, what he did is he came up and illustrated the problem with the presentation of the House case. It's been smoke and mirrors, and worse, it's been dishonest. He came up and tried to cover when he got caught, as they were caught earlier today with all of the evidence, checking tweets, switching dates, everything they did. And bear in mind, I had 2 days to look at their evidence. And when I say 2 days, I mean they started putting in their evidence, so I started to be able to get looking at it. That is not the way this should be done. But what we discovered was he knew what he was doing. He knew that the president didn't say that to his people. What he said was, if it happened to the Dems, this is what they would do. In his speech that day, you know what he said? He said, if this happened to the Democrats, if the election was stolen from the Democrats, all hell would break loose. But, he said to his supporters, we are smarter, we are stronger, and we're gonna do what they did all summer long. So what he did was he misrepresented a tweet to you to put forth the narrative that is wrong. It's wrong, it's dishonest, and the American people don't deserve this any longer. You must acquit.
Managers on the part of the House of Representatives have 2.5 minutes.
And that was profoundly inaccurate and irrelevant to what the question is. So I'm going to get back to the question. So under Article 2, Section 4, a president who is in office must be convicted before removal, then must be removed before disqualification. Okay. But if the president is already out of office, then he can be separately disqualified, as this president is. But these powers have always been treated as separate, which is why I think there have been 8 people who've been convicted and removed, and just 3 of them disqualified. And as you know, there's a totally separate process within the Senate for doing this. The Constitution requires 2/3 vote for conviction, but for disqualification, it's a majority vote. It's a separate thing. So people could vote to convict and then vote not to disqualify. If they felt that the evidence demonstrated that the president was guilty of incitement to insurrection, they could vote to convict. But if they felt that they didn't want to exercise the further power established by the Constitution to disqualify, they wouldn't have to do that. And that could be something that's taken up separately by the Senate by majority vote.